Hi, my name is Ivan Osia. I live in Mwatoto Bira. I'm a football player. God has given me this gift to change the world. I've grown up in Mwatoto. I've had very many opportunities. In 2013, I was blessed with an opportunity to travel to Spain for football. And I had a good experience. I got to learn a lot from big teams there. I believe I'm going to go back and become a professional footballer. I believe God is going to do great things in my life. I'm a product of sponsorship. I also have a lot of father figures in Mwatoto, pastors, youth workers, social workers. I have a coach, and he is also like a father figure in my life. I want to thank all the men that sponsor a child in Mwatoto. You're making a very big difference because you're like a father figure to them.
Hey everyone, welcome to church. Let's sing these words together as we party for Jesus. Come on.
Breaking open every tide of mine. Your love is breathing out into my life. You take my burden and you make it light. You make it light.
Bringing a sound.
Bringing a sound that will break the night. I choose to follow you for all my life. I know that you were always by my side. You're by my side. In everything we do, we choose to praise you. No matter what they say, we will go your way. Listen to your beat.
Come on.
This is how we party. This thing up the name.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, we give you glory.
We give bless you praise. Your name. We love you, Lord. Wherever you are, be reminded that God is able to do far above more than you might think, than you might know, that you might ask. Believe He is able in every circumstance. Thank you, Lord.
Lifted up, He defeated the grave. Raised to life, our God is able. In His name, we overcome. For the Lord, our God is able. Lifted up, He defeated.
So much worship team, indeed our God is able. Welcome to HYD. It simply means how are you doing.
That's right, HYD is a teen service we have right here in Watoto Church, where we engage with you, encourage you, and empower you to be a world changer in your community. My name is Blessed and I am a mofa from Watoto Church Kansanga.
My name is Victor and I'm a youth worker at Watoto Church. In case you're celebrating with us for the very first time, we would love to connect with you. So if you're watching online, click on the link on your screen. But if you're watching on air, kindly write to us, moff.connect@watotochurch.com, or call the number on your screen and we'll be glad to connect with you.
Yes, that's absolutely right. Now it's time to call for our ride or die DJ, DJ Stan.
What's happening? What's happening, my guys? You guys all right?
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Awesome, awesome. It's that time of the day, that time of the service when we jam. So I'm going to invite all of you, your parents, whoever you're with, let's jam. Let's do this right. Come on.
Yeah.
Book of Revelation, chapter
7. Exactly.
You're really taking us back.
We're throwing it back. If you know this track, drop those fire emojis in the comment section. Come on. You have to jam with me. Come on, follow. Keep up. Exactly, Come on. Come on. Now I need to take you back a little bit. If you know this one, let me see you jam. I know some people on set know this one. I know some people on set know this one.
Yeah. Me, some people on this side know that too.
Come on, let me see that salsa. Hey, There we go.
Like that? So if you're home and you're killing it,
Exactly, we're going way back. Hey. Get down.
Don't ever be afraid to talk. For the life where you live will the terms you walk. To live only at the shadow of death me pass.
Come on.
You guys are having too much fun. Let's relax a little bit.
Yeah. But I like the thing how you do on your DJ set. Like,
man,
whoa.
You may think it's part of the music.
Basically,
it's a wow.
It's cool, yeah. But then at the end of the day, for me, DJing is an art of worship. And we have to use what we have to give back to the one who brought us here, who gave us this opportunity to be here.
Wow.
Wow.
That's super amazing. That's super amazing. DJ Steph, do you have any game for us? Okay. You've given us music. Now, do you have a game for
us? Well, today what I need is I want to test and see how you're doing mentally.
Mm.
Oh. Exactly. So I'm just going to ask you to say the alphabet from T to F.
From T to F.
T to F.
That's backward.
Yep.
Are you fine?
Kale, who goes first? Who goes first?
Is no, please.
Oh, who, me?
Yes, you, Victor.
Okay. T, F from F to T.
F to T.
G. F to T or T to F?
T to F.
T to F. T to F. T, T-U-V-W. Okay, T-U, that's going forward. Now, going backward is T-S, T-S-U, right?
I'm not going to cheat for you.
T-S-U.
Blessed. Let's try.
So I think it's T, S, and then R. R. Am I right?
Then R.
Anyways, basically.
Q. We move.
Basically, you have failed.
It's a really jam.
Awesome try.
But that was amazing.
That was amazing.
Yeah.
But you know what's also amazing? Our theme this year, Arise and Shine 2021. We are here going to sum it up in our sermon series by learning how to shine in our community.
Yeah. Shine your light for the world to see your good deeds.
Yes.
Now with me, I have the Epenus. All the way from Watoto Church, Subi, one of the youth workers from Watoto Church, Subi, and they're going to share with us. So grab your pens, grab your Bibles, grab your notebooks, some of them, okay, your juice, porridge, whatever
porridge.
You have, man, just have it ready, set, get ready to receive from them.
Thank you, Victor, Blessed, and DJ Steph. That was awesome. My name is Brian, and this is Claire, my lovely wife.
It's great for us to be here with you today. And I just want to remind us of what happened last Sunday. We talked about the fact that we need to arise and shine as teenagers. Now, our scripture for the whole year, our theme verse is from Isaiah chapter 60, verses 1 to 2. And I'll read from the Amplified Versions. Arise from spiritual depression to a new life. Shine, be radiant with the glory and brilliance of the Lord, for your light has come, and the glory and brilliance of the Lord has risen upon you. For in fact, darkness will cover the earth, and deep darkness will cover the peoples. But the Lord will rise upon you, Jerusalem, and his glory and brilliance will be seen on you. Let's pray. Lord, I thank you that you call us to arise. Then you promise us that your glory will be upon us. Lord, as we talk about how to arise and shine in the community, I pray that you will open our eyes to see the need and go out there and shine for Jesus. In Jesus' name we've prayed.
Amen. Amen. And amen.
Yes.
At Watoto Church, vision is captured in two statements: celebrating Christ, caring for community. Caring for communities in which Jesus has planted us as Watoto Church. As a teenager, you might ask why. And the reason is because Jesus cares about every community.
You know, what you've just shared is really profound. Jesus cares about every community. But you know, a teenager out there might be asking, what is community? And we asked a couple of them what community really is. And some said, community is people I meet, it's the friends I interact with, it is my family, it is my neighbors. Do you think they were right?
Yes, they were right. Community is really about the people that live in that community.
Yeah.
Secondly, it's also about the state or the condition of that community. Now, here is what we learn from Jesus, how he cared about community. Jesus wept over the spiritual ignorance of Jerusalem. Luke chapter 19, verse 41 says, as he approached Jerusalem, he saw the city and wept over it and the spiritual ignorance of its people. Jesus also cared for the needs of the people in his community. Acts chapter 10, verse 38 tells us how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with great power. And he went around doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil because God was with him. Above all, Jesus commanded us to care for those around us. And the Bible tells us in Mark chapter 12, verse 30 to 31, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this: love your neighbor as you love yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. Yes.
And you know, I like what you've said. Yeah. And love is the core of the way we do life at Watoto Church. And you know, it started for us with a special journey God took our founder, Pastor Gary, through. Now, you know, Pastor Gary had a very young family. And God told him, come to Uganda. Go to Uganda. And then God gave him a very special command. He told him, take care of my children. Now, Pastor Gary struggled with that. Remember, he also had a young family. But God was very, very clear. And he told him, I did not bring you here to do what you want to do. I brought you here to do what I want you to do. Take care of my children. And he knew then that God was talking about the orphan child. Now, James chapter 1, verse 27 tells us that we need to take care of the orphan. So that's when Watoto Child Care Ministries was born. And all these children were rescued and given hope. And later on, Watoto Neighborhood also was established. And that takes care of the vulnerable woman, restoring her dignity. Now, I have been a youth worker and I still serve at Watoto Church Suvi. And I have seen firsthand how God is transforming young people into godly, transformational leaders that are rebuilding this nation. Now, God also asked Pastor Gary a question. Who owns community? And you know, Pastor Gary gave a very foolish answer, but God told him that the problems of community are for God to deal with. And you know, God deals with the problems of community by using his people. Yeah. And you know, young person, guess who those people are? Those people are us, the church, me and you. Yeah. And you know, that's when God transitioned us in 1997 to become a cell-based community church. Now, the idea is that every individual belongs to a small group. Now, in this small group, there is fellowship, there is discipleship, there is evangelism. And that small group will work with the members of the community to deal with the different community needs. And in that way, we are shining a light, honey. We are shining a light to everyone around us. We are pointing people to Jesus. That's the idea. Yeah. And that changed the way we did ministry as Watoto Church. And I have been in Watoto Church for the past 18 years. And immediately I joined, I was plugged into a cell. But one thing I found out is you cannot just do community transformation just like that. You can't just care for community on your own. We all need a revelation from the Holy Spirit. Young person, you need to tell God to open your eyes to see the need in your community. You know, some people are frustrated with school, and you're good at mathematics or you're good at history, and you can reach out to them. Others are frustrated with family, and you can stand with them and pray with them and walk with them and encourage them. Others are frustrated with purpose. And God wants us to work together and point all these people to Jesus, because the good news is that Jesus is the only one who can fix our brokenness. And we need to shine the light of Christ for everybody, honey.
Wow, that's amazing. I like how Isaiah chapter 60 verse 3 puts an emphasis on that. It says, nations will be drawn to your light. Honey, you know, it's so clear that God wants us to arise and shine with God's love and touch our communities. And when we do that, the darkness that is covering these people will be lifted away from them. And that will also present us with an opportunity to point these people to Jesus, who is the light of the world. One great example we have is Nehemiah. Nehemiah was visited by his brother Hanani. Nehemiah had been in exile. And you know, when his brother came, he told Nehemiah that the walls had been broken and the gates had been burnt. When Nehemiah heard about this, he was troubled and he prayed to God. And God answered him. God granted Nehemiah favor, and Nehemiah went to the king. And this is what the Bible says in Nehemiah chapter 2 and verse 8. And the king granted this request because the gracious hand of God was on me.
I like what you just said. The gracious hand of God was on Nehemiah. The gracious hand of God is on you right now. His favor is on us as a church. His presence is with us. Now, God wants you to go and shine the light of his love in your school. Wherever you go, God wants you to shine his light. And at that time, you're going to be pointing everyone to Jesus. And the more we do that, the more we shine the light of Christ. And you might wonder, how can I do this? Through acts of love, through your generosity, you helping someone with a discussion because you're good at that subject. Go shine the light to your peers. Go shine the light of Jesus where he has placed you.
And you know, God wants us to be practical in our care for community. God wants us to do something about the brokenness and the pain of people in our communities. I remember at the beginning of last year, there was a lady in our neighborhood who was struggling, and our cell reached out to her. One of the greatest needs that she had was that of a latrine. And so we came together, put some money, and then we helped this lady construct a latrine. She was so excited. You know, as the year came to an end, this lady lost her job because of COVID. And so, as a cell, we came together again and we went over to her place with some supplies. We took for her some things to celebrate Christmas with. And she was so excited that we had visited her and taken for her some of the things that she needed to carry her through Christmas and even the time after. Teens, you know, God wants you to do something in your community. Remember, you are a world changer. So step out and arise and shine.
And you know, you may be wondering, where do I start? First things first, join a cell. Now, like I said, a cell is a small group of Watoto Church members that come together for fellowship, discipleship, evangelism, but more so they are shining the light of Jesus in the community, and they are doing so many acts of love. And there's an encouraging verse in the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 10, verses 24 to 25. This is what it says. Let us think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works. Let us not neglect our meeting together as some people do. You listen to that. But encourage one another, especially now that the day of his return is drawing near. The thing is that God has called us to be a cell-based community church, and we're encouraging you to join a cell today. And if you don't know how to go about that, write to us, moff.connect@watotochurch.com, or just contact the number on the screen for more guidance.
Another way for you to get involved is to give. Giving expands the kingdom of God. The Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 25, verse 40. I tell you the truth, when you did it to one of the least of these my brothers and sisters, you were doing it to me. God would like us to give him our time, our talents, and our treasures. And our treasures include things like our tithe, our offering, and our finances to care for community. Finally, another way through which you can get involved is to pray. Amen. Prayer is very important for us. The Bible tells us in 1 John chapter 5, verse 14, and we are confident that he hears us whenever we ask for anything that pleases him. And since we know that he hears us when we make our requests, we also know that he will give us what we ask for. Wow, that's amazing. This is a great vision from God, and I believe God is calling each and every member of Watoto Church to get down on their knees every day and pray that God would continue to help us remain faithful, committed, and passionate about caring for communities. Teens, community is close to the heart of God. And so we just want to encourage you out there to step out and get involved. Don't just watch. One of the greatest darkness that I know is that of sin. You could be out there and probably you do not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. If that's you, I'd like to lead you in this prayer. Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I ask you to forgive me. Come into my heart and be my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, if you just said that prayer, you have become a child of God, and all of heaven is right now rejoicing over that one decision that you have made. But you could also be out there and probably you're wondering, what can I do? I would like to just lead you in a prayer. Father in heaven, I just want to thank you for the people out there who are struggling, Lord. I just pray that may you help them use their time, their talents, and their treasures to care for people in their communities. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much for joining us. I will now hand over the service to Blessed and Victor.
Wow, that was such an amazing conversation.
Oh, yes, it was. What stood out for you, Blessed?
What stood out for me was the talk about prayer and giving in your cell to impact on your community.
Yes, talking about cell. In case you're at home wondering how to be a part of a cell group, just email us moff.connect@pototochurch.com or you can DM us on our social media platforms.
And on that note, we have our friend King Sema,
yep,
who we would love to appreciate here for hitting on our DMs.
True, I'm sure he's having a great time. Now, in case you're wondering how to give, because it's about time for us to give, at the top of the hour during the main service, the giving instructions will be on your screen. Please stay tuned and make sure you give.
Yes, and that's all for now. But yep, please don't forget to hit our social media of Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. See you next Sunday at 9.
Bye.
Oh, What Love went out and literally has changed the world. Thank you so much for praying for us. Because of your prayers and your support, Oh What Love has been a great success. We've seen so many people come to Christ. We've seen people being encouraged that have been going through like divorce. So many people have signed up to partner with Wototo. And because of that, we're having so many lives right now in Uganda being changed because of this production. I'm sitting here with four miracles. These are some of the children at Wototo that were rescued as babies. And today they're traveling the world telling people what God can do. I cannot wait to see them 20 years down the road and see what they have become. Because I know that God has a plan for each and every one of these children. So I want to say thank you so much. We pray that God will bless you.
Thank you.
Welcome, 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 children in the house of God. I hope you are excited about today. I am so excited. All right, right now, I'm just going to give you a minute. I want you to wake up. I'm going to ask you to stretch. I'm going to request from a drum roll. So I want you to shake your body, shake your hand, turn around, turn around, turn around. Make sure wherever you are so that we are ready to be in the house of God. Are you excited? All right, all right. Thank you, thank you. I want to find out, do you remember our theme of the year as a church? Can you shout it out loud? What is the theme again? What is our theme again? Arise and shine. Surely arise and shine. Today we are coming to God in prayer. We're going to ask God to guide us so that we can rise as children and we shine in everything He wants us to do. So, right about now, I'm going to... Have you thought about it? Actually, we are in 2021 and the month of January has come to an end. Has God been good to you? He has been good to me. I want right now to start, before I open up with a word of prayer, I want you to pray to God. We're going to give thanks. Can you pray to God and ask Him, thank you for my parents, thank you for my life, thank you for food, thank you for protecting us. There are so many things we can say thank you to God for. Right now, can you ask God, can you tell Him, what are you thankful for? We are praying, children. I want you to tell God what you are thankful for. Jesus, we thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for our parents. Thank you that, Lord, you've provided food we've not lacked. Thank you for shelter. Thank you for protecting us, Lord, for healing diseases where we've been sick. We are so grateful that you love us, and we are grateful that you are here with us. So, Lord, as we continue with our service, as we are going to pray today, praying for our nation, praying for our personal needs, praying for the church, we pray that Holy Spirit, you will come and guide us. We thank you, we honor you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. So, children, let's dance together, and then we're going to come back and we pray to God through some things that you have mentioned. Amen.
All right, get up on your feet and let's dance and sing for Jesus. Are you ready? Are you ready, children? Come on. Hey, just dance like this. Hey, hey, hey. All right, let's sing together.
We will not be shaken.
We're marching.
We will not be moved.
love. Ha. Whoa, oh, 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 oh.
Let's sing together.
Here we go.
Never let go, never let go of you.
Never let go.
So lift up your hands, children, as we sing this song, and just declare to God that I am yours. I know you love me. I know you care for me. I know you know the plans that you have for me, and they are good. Thank you, Jesus. Let's sing together.
I am chosen, not forsaken. I am who you say I am. You are for me, not against me. I am who you say I am.
Let's sing.
I am chosen, not forsaken. I am who you say I am. You are for me, not against me. I am who you say I am.
Sing it again.
I am chosen, not forsaken.
Children, the song that we've been singing today reminds both of us, you and I, that we are children of God. And being a child of God means that when you talk to Him, just like every other parent, God hears you and listens to you. You and I have needs. Needs are the requests that you and I are believing God for. And guess what? Jesus in his word reminds us to give him all our cares. Because he cares for you, he'll listen. So I'm going to ask you right where you are to close your eyes and with your beautiful voice, tell God about the things you're believing him for. Jesus, thank you that someone out there that is sick and is believing you for healing, you're making them fine. You're making them complete. You're making them whole. Some of us, Lord, we are believing you for wisdom. We are believing that you'll help us understand the things that we're doing at school. We're also hoping that school fees, you will provide for it. God, we ask you to protect our parents. Your word asks us to honor them. Teach us to respect them. Teach us to love them. Teach us to obey them. We ask, Lord, that you'd bless our parents. Some of them, because of COVID, have lost their jobs. Father, we ask that our mummies and our daddies, you'd give them work that would bring in money. Some of us, Lord, we're believing you for food at home. We ask that you'd provide the money so that mommy and daddy can provide for it as well. And God, we're also believing some of us and our brothers and sisters, we probably have bad habits. We lie. We don't speak the truth. We're asking you to teach us to speak truth. We're asking you to teach us to be children that respect authority. We're asking you to guide us, to protect us, Jesus. Lord, we're believing you for health. We are believing that we shall be fine. That candidate that's out there, we are believing that you're going to be the head and not tail. We're going to trust that you're going to come out well in the exam that you're going to sit. Jesus, we thank you that when we pray, when we talk to you, you hear us and you answer us. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Let's continue worshiping God as we sing.
Together, children.
Let justice fill this nation. Have mercy, Jesus, please forgive our sin. Take the heart of stone away. Teach our hearts to bow. Your kingdom come, let your will be done. Amen, amen. In this nation, as it is in heaven. Amen, amen. Let your kingdom come, let your will be done.
Children, the song we just sang is a prayer asking God to bless Uganda. Right now, you and I are going to pray for this nation. We just got new leaders elected in. Pray that the leaders will get wisdom from God to make the best decisions. Pray that they will work together in unity and that there will be peace in our nation. That people will not fight and there will be no riots or wars. pray that the Ugandan economy will become better, that all the businesses will come back and people will get their jobs back. Pray that everyone will be able to make money to take care of themselves and their families. Pray that COVID-19 will go far away from us, that we'll never have to worry about it again. Lord, we thank you that you've heard our prayer for our nation, Uganda. And we thank you because you've done everything we've asked for. In Jesus' name. And all God's children say, amen. Let's continue to worship together.
Now we, your people, called by your name, humble ourselves and return to seek your face. Lord, hear from heaven, draw near, heal our land.
We sing.
Now we, your people, seek your face, Lord, hear from heaven, draw near, heal our land.
Now we your people,
now we your people, call by your name, humble ourselves and return to seek your face.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, children, for joining us in prayer. We are going to continue praying. I'm so grateful that you are standing on behalf of our nation, that we are praying for our needs. But right now, before I continue to pray, I'm wondering, are you sure you are a person of Jesus? Some of us might be here and we do not know Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior. I want to pray with you so that as we continue to pray together, we are sure Jesus is ours. So if you know you do not know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, could you please repeat this prayer with me? Could you say, "Dear Jesus, I know I am a sinner. Can you please forgive me of my sins and come into my heart and be my personal Lord and Savior? In Jesus' name, amen." If you've prayed that prayer, from today, you are a child of God. And the Bible tells us in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14, that if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, so will I hear them from heaven and I answer their needs, their prayers. So God is ready to listen to us as we continue to pray. So right now, I would like us to pray for the church of Jesus. We have a responsibility to preach the gospel that everyone who is lost will come to the saving knowledge of Jesus. So I want you to take this moment, children, just pray for the church of Jesus. Everyone who is saved, that the Holy Spirit will give them boldness to tell people who do not know Jesus about Jesus, that the Holy Spirit will use you and me to bring people in that do not know Jesus. I also want us to take this moment and we pray for the church as Watoto Church. We have needs, we have a vision, things that we're going to do this year 2021, And we can't do it by ourselves. We need God. We need God to come and intervene and help us. So I want you to lift up Watoto Church. Our theme for the year is Arise and Shine. That you, as the church of God in Watoto, you will help us to shine everywhere you are. That we will see God help us reach out and rescue vulnerable women, vulnerable children, those that do not have food, don't have shelter, can't access medical, they can't go to school, that God will provide, and we see children being provided for just like you and me. Continue to pray, lifting up the needs of the church. Right now, I'm going to invite Favor. Favor, please come and lead us in the prayer for the church.
Oh, Heavenly Father, thank you for this day you've made for us. Thank you for keeping us safely from coronavirus. And pray so that you can bless the church, Watoto Church, and help it spread around the whole world so that everybody can praise your holy name. Pray so that you can bless those people who have just come today. Change their life and make it new. Pray so that you can help all of us. And please bless us and keep us safely due to this time. In Jesus' name I have prayed.
Amen, amen, and amen. Thank you so much, Favor. And thank you for every child who has been praying with us today. Thank you. I'm sure Jesus has heard our prayers in heaven, and he's going to do something about what we've been requesting. Don't worry, we're going to continue. We're going to continue sing and dance as we end together. So right now, I want to pray with you, leave you a blessing in your homes, your school, your work, and everything that you're doing. So would you allow me, close your eyes so I can pray with you as we continue. Jesus, I thank you for every child. I thank you for every family that has been praying as we've been praying together. Even those that do not know you, we are praying that, Lord, they will come to the saving knowledge of your power. Thank you, Lord, for the opportunity you've given to us to stand on behalf of our nation, on behalf of our church, and even bringing our needs to you. We know that, Lord, everything we pray for is yes and amen in you. Father, may you bless your people, provide for your children. May your favor rest upon them. May you, Lord, may they be healed from any diseases, because you know for us, no one can be against us. We love you. In Jesus' name we've prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. So we're going to continue to dance. Can we dance some more?
Yeah.
Are you ready to dance some more?
Yes.
Let's dance some more. Auntie Charlotte.
All right, everybody, like this. Good job. All right, let's sing together.